I'm sketching at McMinimum's in Eugene, Oregon. And as usual, my model just moved, but they're beautifully backlit. They're sitting against a window. They're drinking martinis. They look like they're having a lot of fun. So I'm just doing a sketch, and I'll go in with colored pencils very soon. This is a very minimal sketch, but the beauty of using a ballpoint pen, so fast. And as you know, when you're out in life, speed is everything because things are changing all the time. So when you're painting and drawing from life, flexibility is everything. And just, you're going to lose your subject, so be as quick as you can. And just try to flow with it and relax. So what if you end up with a composite? This picture might may be a composite of several other people. So a lot of it is your attitude and just not getting uptight. That's part of why we do it. It teaches us to just flow.
What are you doing there, Peter?
I'm trying to listen to Cheryl and do the similar subject. And I'll color it later, like Cheryl. Just trying to get the outlines, and I agree with her. I like the silhouettes. I like the backlit function with the river outside the window and the trees outside the window and the talking heads and nice glass drinks on the sunlit table. It's a lot to like. There's also a little bunch of flowers and bays.
I'm choosing my colors right now, and even though this is a sunny day, I'm looking out at a very sunny window, and I'm in a relatively dark bar. It's very hard for me to see the colors that I actually have, but I'm going through and doing the best I can, and the first thing I'm going to do is figure out my like dark pattern. So if you can see what I'm actually working on, I'm looking outdoors, and the tree trunks are the darkest thing. And then the figures will be the next darkest. Because colored pencils are somewhat difficult to get extreme darks, I'm going through and picking out the colors that I know are very dark, regardless of what it looks like in front of me. I'm choosing Toucan Red, a really great color called Black Grape. I have Indigo, and a dark green called Cerise. No, excuse me, this is called Black Cherry. I decided to approach the tree first. It's my darkest dark, but I laid down an undercoat of metallic silver, and now I'm going in with the Black Cherry. And the idea is to get a colorful dark. And the underlying message here is that I put my black away, even though it comes in the kit, and I would prefer that you wouldn't use it. You can make your own beautiful signature darks just by mixing the darks that you have. So this one is Black Cherry, and this one is called Toucan Red. They're very similar, actually. And you can mix those colors up. And then let's go into Black Grape. I want you to see the range that I'm going for here on these values. Now that Black Grape looks like black, but it's not. It has a lot of purple in it, and it's more attractive than just going with plain black.
Our models have left, but I'm coloring in the quick ink sketch that I did. And when I sketch like this, at a site like this, I may or may not make it into a larger drawing, but I just like to see if I can capture the essence of where I'm at, and then just leave it in my notebook as just a daily scene, or work it up into a drawing or even a cartoon.
We're moving to a medium green. Should be able to see this a little better. And this is parrot green. It's very, very bright, but this is an extremely bright day. It's spring, and so we're gonna go overboard with how bright this green actually is. If I want to naturalize it, I can always put red in it a little bit later. So I'm continuing, but I'm thinking about varying the size of the leaves a little bit. I'm just making circles, but I'm making some larger, some smaller. Okay. So we have two layers of green on the tree, and in order to indicate the branches, I used a color called indigo. And indigo is one of the very few that are very, very dark in colored pencil, and it's an essential color. And this is a much better choice than using black. Now, even though there is a green river behind them, I like this dramatic dark light effect. I'm feeling that it's enough information. I'm just enjoying the sketch. It already changed out twice for the number of people that were there, so I didn't start with the original women that were there. They turned into guys. So this is a sketch. It will remind me of where I was. I'll probably write down the name of the place, and I'll remember it forever. So Peter, the reason that we do sketching in bars and in our everyday life is to preserve memories, to just let go of it being a perfect sketch. And I can come back here, and I do come back and look at my sketches years later, and I know where I was on that day, who I was with. And it's just an impression, but it's an indelible impression. And this is not finished art. You may not hang it on the wall.
Right.
But it is deep memory because you've hardwired it into your body in more ways than one. You're not just remembering it and seeing it. You're actually creating it.
Good.
So it's in there.
It is. Good.
Thank you. I think I might have been a little bit. Whatever it is.